If America could be, once again, a nation of self-reliant farmers, craftsmen, hunters, ranchers, and artists, then the rich would have little power to dominate others, neither to serve nor to rule. That was the American dream. America began as a nation of craftsmen. Figures like Benjamin Franklin believed that economic self-reliance was a powerful aspect of sturdy individualism. Influential transcendentalists such as Thoreau and Emerson placed a heavy value on self-reliance and living a simple life, void of imitation or cutting corners. But this changed in the 1820s with the Industrial Revolution. Through assembly lines, factory electrification, and machines running 24 hours of the day, products were mass-produced at a rate unrivaled by human hands. We've chosen to explore a group of Americans fueling a modern counter-industrial revolution of sorts. Micro-entrepreneurs individually hand-make and sell their own unique goods through online marketplaces or local fairs and boutiques. Their values align themselves with the thoughts of Franklin, Abbey, Nagel, and other American theorists. Similar to the Shakers, who devoted their lives to handcrafting, these modern-day entrepreneurs are committing their time to producing products that they believe in.
My name is Sarah Oliver, and I make hand-knit handbags. You make something with your hands, you feel like you've accomplished something, that you have a result to show people, so that's a good feeling. And it's also a skill that can be passed down from generation to generation.
My name is Astrid, and I make hand-embroidered jewelry as well as home decor. The pro is that I'm the one that's designing and I'm making it, and I actually enjoy it. It's therapeutic for me, and I love to be the designer and the maker and involved in all elements of the aspect of the business and the design aspects.
So my name is Tracy Diamond. I've been working at 7 on Locust. I've been here since March of this year. We sell handmade, handcrafted, hand-forged items from local artisans. So we sell jewelry, we sell handbags, we sell clothing.
My name is Jenny Miller. I'm the operations assistant at Renegade Craft Fair. We're based in Chicago. We've been around since 2003. And we put on big, large-scale events where we're a platform for handmade artists.
My name is Molly DeVries, and my company is Ambataya for a Non-Disposable Life. I was a hairdresser for 20 years, and I wanted to do something that was more meaningful to me and more passionate. With a year of kind of investigating that question, I came up with handmade. When you make something that's valuable and you don't cut corners and you value the people that make it, that shows up.
The trend of mass-produced goods to feed America's growing demand is unwavering. American consumption has doubled since 1957. Up until the 1960s, America produced 95% of its own clothing. Today, we outsource 97% of clothing production to developing countries around the world. Low prices and quantity are valued above regard for the quality of the product or the energy that went into creating it.
I feel like that part of our industry in terms of fashion and in terms of the problems all over the world, the people aren't being taken care of with fair wages because the competition is so heavy and people keep wanting the prices to be cheaper and they're not valuing people's lives at make. I just don't think people realize how much work goes into something very simple.
I have had people approach me to mass produce, but that would sort of defeat the purpose because it is all hand embroidered, and also it's something that I love doing personally. That's what we love to do, is have our hands in the making process.
In the past few years, there's been a mass influx in the popularity of handmade goods. Etsy, the most popular online handmade marketplace, has seen a 90% spike in users since 2011. A major reason for the rise is the fact that handmade products allow people to have a deeper buyer-to-seller connection in a way that mass-produced items cannot.
The connection with an artist who made something like makes you feel connected to the things that you have. There's a lot that people like about something that's personal. And I think that, and I actually have a lot of feelings about this, but I think that like the rise of like wanting to feel like an individual in a time where you're feeling like anxious or like alienated by kind of like a mainstream culture, I think that, you know, there's something about like wanting something that's unique and feels like it's just for you.
My background is in psychology, so I do understand people, so I think of it more along the lines of what people really need and want nowadays, And I think it does have to do with how things are so disconnected lately, and you know, people are more isolated, and so they want more of a story or a connection to things.
But I saw it at trunk shows. It's really direct, like interaction. I'm there, like I'm talking. People will ask questions, like, oh wow, like, well, how did you get the idea for this? Or like, it's a much more interactive process.
And when Ellie creates her pieces, we don't keep them in the shop very long, because again, they come in, people see them, they're connected to them, and they buy it.
I absolutely feel like I'm connecting with my customers by selling the handmade goods, especially in our case, because we have a story associated with our brand.
America was built on the value of individual entrepreneurship. And although the current mainstream market is filled with large-scale capitalism and repetitive mass production, these individual makers are bringing back the respect of self-reliance, individualism, and the value of quality over quantity that was seen prior to the Industrial Revolution.
It's just, there's so much involved when you're making something that I hope people value, and those are the best kind of people that value and ask questions and notice it's something special.
Way back when, things were made by hand and they were made in America. Owning your own business is the American dream, and being an entrepreneur is how you go about doing it.